tico-tico, tick, oh tico-tico, tock. This tico-tico, he's a cuckoo in my clock. And when he says cuckoo, he means it's time to woo. It's tico time for all the lovers in the block. I've got a heavy date, a tete-a-tete at 8. So speak, oh tico, tell me, is it getting late? If I'm on time, cuckoo, but if I'm late, woo-woo, the one my heart has gone to may not want to wait. For just a birdie and a birdie who goes nowhere, he knows of every lover's lane and how to go there. For in affairs of the heart, my tico's terribly smart. He tells me gently, sentimentally at the start. Oh, oh, I hear my little tico, tico calling, because the time is right and shades of night are falling. I love that not so cuckoo, cuckoo in the clock. Tico, 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 tock. I've got a day that ain't hard to celebrate with my friend Tico, Tico, Tock. A birdie who goes nowhere, he knows of every lover's lane and how to go there. For in affairs of the heart, my tico's terribly smart. He tells me gently, sentimentally at the start. Oh, oh, I hear my little tico, tico calling to me. The time is right, the shades of night are falling. I love that not so cuckoo, cuckoo in the clock. Tico, 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 tock.
What made you think of going into BOAC?
Well, I had itchy feet, and they had advertised, and I went along to this office, and they said, "Oh, what a pity!" Because they advertised BOAC advertised for their first ever stewardesses, and it was closed yesterday. So they phoned up BOAC, and BOAC put me on the end of their list of people to be interviewed.
Wow,
and
so
I managed to get
that.
In they only took 12 of us. They'd interviewed 300 out of 3,000, they told us. We got on very well. We did some of our training. First of all, we did some in London, and then we went, we had quite a hard time because the restaurant people in Imperial House in Buckingham Palace Road, which was BOAC's headquarters at that time, they'd gone on strike, and they took us there to take the place of the waitresses underneath in the restaurant. London Airport, even for flying boats, shall I take you down to the people coming on board?
Yes, please do, yes. Yeah.
I would, but by 6:30 I would be at Airways Terminal, which is in Buckingham Palace Road then.
This is in the morning?
In the morning.
Yeah.
And I'd be introduced to my passengers, and there would be about 36 of them or so. And we'd get on a coach, and we'd drive down to the Hog's Back, where we went into a hotel and had breakfast. And so by the time we all got back, people knew each other fairly well. And went down to Southampton, and I would leave them and go and join the stewards, who by that time they'd got the thing over there. I'm not talking about the first time which I came from Poole, the first time I joined from Poole, but this was only the very, very first time. But apart from that, this was the practice.
So when you went from Poole, you would do the same thing? You would take the passengers from London on a coach
down? I cannot remember how the passengers got down, because I was down here the night before and saw that with the stewards that all the stuff was loaded properly onto the aeroplane. And I stayed at the Harbour Heights that time. That was the only time. The flying boat was very comfortable for the passengers. It was fairly comfortable for us, I suppose. But it had its own atmosphere, because It had had a recreation, the promenade deck where the passengers could walk up and down or go into the lounge at the back or go to the bar, which was at the top of the stairs because there were stairs, up and down stairs in the flight.
So there would be two flights. There would be two levels.
Two levels, yes.
And the passengers would sit below?
No, the passengers would, there would be, I think, eight below, and the rest would be upstairs. Going as we went up from London, the first one, I remember that we had flowers on the table, but we've always put tablecloths on and laid proper places. Wow. and gave them silver service all the time.
And how many stewardesses would there have been on these flights?
Just the one. One steward and, well, two stewards. We called them the galley steward, that was the second steward, and the chief steward and one stewardess.
So the chief steward would be in charge of the three of you?
No, the chief steward would be in charge of the food. He wouldn't be in charge of the stewardess. The stewardess was the captain's responsibility. I'll tell you one thing that struck in my mind. This was landing on the Zambezi. We used to land above Victoria Falls. Mm. And the river was fairly narrow because the launch came out to take us in, of course. And I had one of the American ladies on board, and she suddenly screamed, and I said, "Oh, what's the matter?" And she pointed up, and there was, where the trees were overhanging, there was a snake hanging out over the top, and he'd got half a monkey hanging from his mouth.
Trinidad, they make you feel so very glad. Calypso sing and make up rhyme, guarantee you one real good fine time. Drinking rum and coke.